Main Street Asset Management CIO Aaron Gibbs is here, and Geltrude & Company founder Dan Geltrude as well. It's great to have you both here. And Aaron, we'll start with Powell. You know, we don't know what he's going to do in an hour, what he'll say, but if he kind of reiterates what we've heard from him before, it's we're going to react to the data, we're going to stay the course. That's 50 basis points for December.
Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much where the bets are. So I think that will keep the markets sort of steady. Now, we've had 4 days of sort of risk off, markets down. I don't think it's going to make the markets jump up. I think we'll sort of stay in this risk off trend of sort of retracing a bit of the euphoria, sort of the euphoric sentiment that was in October, that started mid-October, mm-hmm. and just sort of stay the course, because we're still really just waiting until December. It's, you know, I doubt.
In what way, though? What do you mean?
Until the actual numbers come.
Okay.
Until the actual until the December meeting.
Okay. I'm like waiting for something else to change. But
yeah.
At this point,
so
I think we're on
have
course.
To say something dramatic, like something really shocking.
No, this is Jay Powell. I'm predicting nothing shocking. But anyway, Dan, what do you say? I mean, it's, you know, he does move markets. He's done it before. We'll see what happens today.
Right. I mean, who knows exactly what he's thinking, but it seems like the general consensus is he's going to go 50 basis points. You and I had spoken before, and I said, you know, I think he's going to go 75. Now, I actually think he should go 75. Why?
Do you like red numbers, Dan?
Well,
do you like economic destruction? Sorry.
Well, it's for a different reason, right? So I see it this way. He is pushing us towards recession. There's no question about it. And that's the end game, to get rid of inflation. So why not just go in? What he's been doing to this point hasn't really been solving the inflation problem. Yes, it's coming down a little bit, but the dramatic steps that he's taken, still not working. But the recession, that's working.
I don't know, Aaron. I mean, what do you say to that?
No, I would say actually, like, inflation has come down. We've had about 5 months of a declining trend. No, it shouldn't happen dramatically, because that usually causes more turmoil. And I, you know, just looking at the job reports, we're not heading into recession so far. We're still heading towards slower growth. Let's remember, we still have 1.7 jobs for every person that's looking for a job. And so that's still a robust economy. And if we do have slowing GDP growth, and obviously we've seen revisions that look like third quarter was a little better, mm-hmm. We're not looking at a massive contraction.
Well, so, you know what, Aaron? Here's what I think is happening. We're all getting kind of numb to this data. And what I mean by that is we're at 7.7% CPI, and we're saying, well, that's a positive sign, because directionally, okay, it's coming down. But that's still a terrible number. And
But you can't undo, it took us 18 months to get there. You can't undo it in 3 months. And so I think if it takes us 9 to 12 months to slowly undo it without causing a massive recession, that's a more healthy trend for just general sanity.
Well, but what we've heard from Bullard and from Williams, to be clear already this week, is that, you know, they believe that we stay the course. And that means we're going to be hiking rates until the middle of 2023, the summer. And unfortunately, what that's doing is that another couple of quarters of negative growth, I think, is very possible because of that. And you hate to see it,
right?
Because Americans are already suffering under higher inflation.
Absolutely.
You know, a lot of companies are starting to lay off. And you, we're not seeing that in the data yet, but I think today might be the final little tip to say, okay, you're going to start to see those layoff notices really. And ADP said today, in that weak number, it was under 27,000. They said, you know, workers are not really quitting now.
Right.
They're looking around and going, oh, I don't have a better offer.
Right.
Guess I'll stay right where I'm at right now.
But
that's the first tip.
I think then that's more of saying that we're just in a more normalized economy versus a red hot economy. Mm-hmm. And if we get through, look, I know it's not that I don't think we'll hit a recession, but if we can just handle a two-quarter recession, the U.S. market is very good at bouncing back. Now, a lot of it has to do with what else is going around in the world. It's not just Powell that could really be able to pull us in or out in the longer term, but two-quarter recession is something that Americans, at least for now, have enough cash, enough jobs to get through, though it may be painful.
They are digging into their savings, though.
Exactly. Really
good. And going to credit cards. Look, yep, we're on a path of death by a thousand cuts, right? And we're attacking the demand side when this is a supply side issue. So, I mean, that's the path we've taken. It's not the right path, but...
I love this conversation. You guys can go have this in the hallway. I got to do something else. Thank you. It's great to have you both here. Love it. All right. Dan, react to the president. According to him, everything is rosy and wonderful.
How about that? Well, first of all, I need to correct the president in terms of job creation. This is about job recovery. I mean, he came into office when we were obviously at the valley of jobs disappearing because people simply couldn't work because of the pandemic. So now we have this job recovery that's going on, but let's not forget, still 10 million job openings out there. The question is, why are people not wanting to go back to work?
I'm thinking stimmy checks. No?
Perhaps free money?
Free money?
Yep. Lauren? A lot of stimulus out there.
Yeah.
And as we've seen, yes, there's still a record high where there's a lack of participation. You know, we still see very low participation rates. Now, that may change, just like we saw in the report today, where less people are quitting their jobs. Mm-hmm. That's the first step. But I think, you know, all these headlines around particularly the tech company and the tech industry cutting jobs, that adds a little fear. So that, again, might make people just want to hold on to their job, even if they may not be completely happy.
Yeah. Dan, how do you assess the market right now? Because, you know, look, we're going into December 1st. Here we go. Today's the last trading day of November. Tomorrow's December 1st. And then that's it. Mic drop on 2022. How are you feeling about what you've seen with the markets this year? Obviously, that's the corporate story as far as labor goes, but a lot of these companies are cutting forecasts. The only good numbers I've seen in earnings, at least for this last quarter that we just covered, was the retailers, and it was because of inflation, because consumers are paying more for goods when they go into, you know, a Best Buy or a Walmart.
So I think what we saw in the market to start with, the market was frothy, right? We knew that many of these companies were really overvalued. Well, now reality starts hitting because we are seeing the economy slowing down. So now how are they going to react to that? Okay, well, they start announcing, well, we're not going to do as well as we thought. So new expectations. And on top of that, the easiest way to cut costs, cut labor. And that's exactly what they're doing. But I got to say one thing about what we're seeing going forward. Two companies in particular, Amazon and FedEx. When those companies are laying people off before Christmas, what is that telling us?
Yeah. Amazon, that shocked me when I saw that. And Dan, that really seemed to be kind of the key point in these comments, is that we're going to moderate in December. Fed funds futures switching gears on that one.
Well, I'm going to say this. I guess everybody could hear what they want to hear and what Jerome Powell said. Here's the way I see it. 2% is still the target rate for inflation. We're around 8%. We're going to keep going on this path. Okay, 50 basis points next month. It's a little bit down from where we thought he would go. But how long is this going to go on for until we can get to 2%? I say that's a long time.
See, so I know you want more aggressive hikes, and I think that's what you're not hearing today from him. What he's saying is that, you know, he also says full effects of Fed tightening yet to be felt, Aaron, and that, you know, and then he says we're still going to hold it for some time. I mean, it's, you know, these are Powell comments, but there's, I mean, he's being pretty clear, I think, that,
yeah,
you know,
we're going to be cautious.
It's going.
It's going. Yeah, it's happening, but we're going to slow it down. We want to take a pause and a breather because, look, last month was, you know, a big enough decline or a big enough cut on the inflationary rate that, look, they've been cautious the entire time, and maybe to Dan's criticism, too cautious. But this is consistent with the Fed of being very cautious. They want to take a breather for 1 month, go down to 50 basis points, look at the impact, because it does take many, many months to really see the impact on that core inflation, which is really the problem that stayed persistent.
Yeah.
And whether they need to go back up next year is a whole nother ball game. But yeah, we're going to be talking about this for a long time.
Well, Dan's point. I don't know what is going to change, Dan, with core. Go ahead. Sorry.
But what I was going to say here is that we're only taking one approach to this, right? We're going to slam demand and not change any policies related to what we have on the supply side.
Don't get me started. On the supply side, we're just making Jerome Powell's job so much harder. And until policymakers really address the fact that they keep adding fuel to the fire and then expecting Powell to put it out is ridiculous.
Absolutely. They're putting too much on the Fed. So it's not necessarily his fault. But what I'm saying is that this is the path we're going down. We got to get to 2%. How long do we want to go on this path of death by a thousand cuts? Maybe we disagree, Aaron, but that's how I see it.
I like moderation.
Okay. I will speak just from a human component that, but what you're talking about, I understand your point about you want to just get it, rip off the Band-Aid, get it over with. If I'm going to break my foot, I'm going to break my foot now, go get some surgery and be over it in a couple of months, right? That's what you're saying. But, the pain that the American consumer, the pain that the American family is going to feel, I don't care what a market does or doesn't based on that, and they're already getting stuck with inflation. Their job losses are coming, cuts are coming. I mean, I'm sorry, but I think it's going to get worse. The job market's going to get worse, and there's more layoffs to come, And so I understand that Powell needs to do what he needs to do, but I just don't want to see that happen to the U.S. economy. If it takes a little more time and the market has to wait, I think I'm okay with that, Aaron.
Yeah, I think that's where maybe I disagree in that. I would rather have slow cuts because at least that gives the U.S. household maybe a little more time. Maybe you don't both lose your jobs. Maybe one of you does. Yeah. I would rather have it slow so that people are able to adjust, handle their households, make changes versus sort of something really drastic where there's massive job cuts and it might affect more households in a much more dramatic way.
Do you really think, Aaron, that right now people are because they're looking at this data. So when you talk about the Main Street, right, and the average person, do you think that they're really saying, oh, things are getting a little better? Not at all. Look how much the prices were up just for Thanksgiving. People are feeling the pain.
No, but we're not saying it's getting better. We're saying at least
it's going to get worse.
But we want it more slowly. Yeah. I'd rather than have it dramatically.
I respect your compassion.
I respect both of you. It's great to have you here. Dan, Aaron, thank you very much. All right.
Thank you.